I've met this morning with my counterparts in the G7, as well as heads of the United Nations, NATO, and the European Union. I express my thanks for the solidarity we have seen as we've stood up an unprecedented global effort. The G7 leaders and the leaders of the EU, NATO, and the UN all agreed that we will stand united in our approach to the Taliban. We talked about our mutual obligation to support refugees and evacuees currently fleeing Afghanistan. The United States will be a leader in these efforts, and we'll look to the international community and to our partners to do the same. And I want to again thank all of our allies and partners around the world who have rallied in support of our shared mission.
The United States is a proud part of the Indo-Pacific. And this region is critically important to our nation's security and prosperity. In this region, we have long put forward a vision of peace and stability, freedom on the seas, unimpeded commerce, advancing human rights, a commitment to the international rules-based order, and the recognition that our common interests are not zero-sum. Now, as we face threats to that order, I am here to reaffirm our commitment to that vision, to strengthen it, and to make sure it addresses the challenges of today and of tomorrow.
Let me begin with my profound appreciation for our diplomats and service members who are working around the clock at the airport in Kabul and at a growing number of transit sites to facilitate the evacuation of Americans, their families, citizens of allied and partner nations, Afghans who have partnered with us over the last 20 years, and other Afghans at risk. They're undertaking this mission under extremely difficult circumstances, with incredible courage, skill, and humanity. More than 24 countries on 4 continents are contributing to the effort to transit, temporarily house, or resettle those who we are evacuating. That didn't just happen. It's the product of an intense diplomatic effort to secure, detail, and implement transit agreements and resettlement commitments. We are deeply grateful to those countries for their generous assistance.
Because of cybersecurity is a global issue, we've also rallied G7 countries to hold nations who harbor ransomware criminals accountable. We updated NATO's cyber policy for the first time in 7 years. And today my team is hosting a meeting bringing together 30 of the nations, 30 nations to step up in their fight against ransomware.
Our two countries working together have a very important and very powerful common agenda, and our commitment to that partnership, to Israel's security, is and always will be unshakable. And we look forward to addressing all of these challenges that we face, particularly regional security and the deep concerns that we share about Iran and the role that it's playing in the region.
Yes. These American service members who gave their lives, it's an overused word, but it's totally appropriate here, were heroes. Heroes who've been engaged in a dangerous, selfless mission to save the lives of others. They're a part of an airlift, an evacuation effort unlike any seen in history, with more than 100,000 American citizens, American partners, Afghans who helped us, and others taking the safety in the last 11 days. Just in the last 12 hours or so, another 7,000 have gotten out. They were part of the bravest, most capable, the most selfless military on the face of the earth. And they're part of simply what I call the backbone of America. They're the spine of America, the best the country has to offer. Here's what you need to know. These ISIS terrorists will not win. We will rescue the Americans in there. We will get our Afghan allies out. And our mission will go on. America will not be intimidated. And I have the utmost confidence in our brave service members who continue to execute this mission with courage and honor to save lives and get Americans, our partners, our Afghan allies out of Afghanistan.